What's up, guys? It's Jake. It's March. It's been a little while. I finally got myself some G Fuel. But more importantly, we do have a really good look at the new protagonist bay and a new stadium for season 6. So let's get right into it. Before we hop into the pictures, if we can get this video up to 800 likes, that would be awesome. I know I have not been uploading that much, but I really do want to get back into it, especially since this new season is going to be coming out very, very soon, which is pretty hype. So let's talk about this new bay. So this picture was originally sent to me by Daigo Kurigami on Instagram, but it is from a YouTube video. And really quick, before I show it, this is the bay without the stickers, and to be honest, it looks a little lame. Not the best of pictures, but let's look at it. Here we go. Here is the bay and all of the parts. As you can see, it is definitely pretty simplified compared to other bays that we've gotten, especially towards the end of even GT and Sparking. It's pretty simple. And like I said, it does not have its stickers, so of course it's gonna look a lot more bland than how it would look normally. So taking a look at the layer first, it does not have a name yet, although I assume it's gonna start with a B because the new main character's name is Ball or Bell. Translation still a little iffy. But the shape is definitely pretty interesting. It has this pretty circular look to it with three major attack points. Really, it's not that aggressive. It's like if Valkyrie was kind of like smushed, was made to be more circular. And fun fact, whenever we got the first initial look at the bay a little while ago, there was rumors that it was going to be like a dark evil Valkyrie, so it definitely kind of looks like it, but yeah, the shape is definitely pretty different. It does look like it's gonna follow the kind of GT and Sparking system idea, where we're gonna have a outer ring and then a chip in the middle. We have the B chip. I don't really know what to call it. I'm just gonna call it B for right now. And it looks to be pretty similar to Sparking, although it doesn't look like there's a core space. Although there's rumored to be kind of like a level chip idea. Really, I don't want to speculate too much because there's just not a lot of info right now. Something that is pretty interesting though is that in between the outer layer portion and the chip on the inside, we see this silver metal ring. Now, I assume that this metal is going to add a decent bit of weight. The bay already looks to be a little bit smaller than the end of Sparking bays, which is good. The bays at the end of Sparking were definitely pretty wide. In this picture, we see a silver kind of weight, but in the original teaser for the bay, it was gold. And it was just very different. It looks to be a completely different metal piece. So it's looking like it's gonna be kind of like a weird mixture of Sparking and GT a little bit. Maybe we have these new weights that are weighing a little bit more than the GT weights. What do you guys think in the comments down below? Now, looking at the disc, this one is pretty interesting because of the fact it looks to be pretty heavy, but it doesn't have any frame kind of slots, so you're not gonna be able to put frames on it. And it also looks to be a normal disc, so it's not gonna be only usable with this new system, kind of like the Limit Break discs were. And if you zoom into the disc a little bit, you can see that the name starts with an N, although there is a second letter or character there, I just can't really make it out. What do you guys think? And kind of unrelated, but if I do update my 3D printed Nitro Bay to this new system, I feel like I'm probably gonna use this disc because it starts with N. That's pretty cool. And then guys, we have the driver, and this one looks to be pretty funky. I'm kind of hoping there is like a simple mode change for it because it looks to be kind of like a beefier version of Unite from Spriggan. We have the plastic kind of spoke in the middle surrounded by rubber, which is just like Unite, but it seems to be a bit wider. And then surrounding that rubber, we have this kind of spiky barbed wire sort of thing, which kind of looks like metal, although I definitely would not bet on it being metal, but that'd be kind of interesting to have like a really upgraded, beefed up version of Unite. But it also would be cool if it could like mode change, so that way you can make it kind of more balanced. You can make it just the rubber popping out so it's more attack type, but I kind of doubt it. I'm pretty sure they're going to keep it kind of simple for this one, so I'm thinking it's just a beefed up Unite. But that is going to wrap it up for what we know about the actual Beyblade itself. I'm definitely looking forward to it. I'm glad it's more simple than kind of the end of sparking. To be honest, with all the limit break bays, I feel like it got a little bit too clunky and too wide. And I'm glad they're kind of dialing it back just a little bit. And this is also the bay without the stickers yet again. So it looks really, really simple. But once we have a better look at it, it's definitely going to look a lot cooler. And guys, we also have what could be a brand new stadium. And this one is kind of interesting because it looks to be bigger. It looks to be wider, and it still has the kind of guard on top, like the pretty much every stadium that's been released for Burst. But it only has two ring out pockets. The reason why I'm saying it's bigger is because if you look at the bottom of the picture, we can see what looks to be a normal grip and a kind of revised string launcher, although I really can't tell by the picture. But if you compare just the sizes of the grip to the stadium looks to be wider than normal. I'm definitely down for that. I definitely feel like the bigger these bays are getting and the heavier they're getting, the standard bay stadium is just getting kind of small now. And even if the stadium is just a little bit bigger, it's definitely going to make a pretty big difference in the long run. I'm definitely down to have a brand new stadium. That would be pretty awesome. And it does make sense that we're getting a stadium set at the beginning of the season, because every single season of Beyblade Burst, we've had like a starter set come out. So that makes sense. And now that I think about the set thing, it is possible that the reason why the bay I showed off earlier has that silver chip instead of a gold one may be because of the fact that it's from a set or something. I'm not really sure. Once again, let me know what you guys think in the comments. But that is going to wrap up this video, guys. Quite a bit of news to talk about, although not the best pictures. I just want to see close-ups of all this stuff. I want Takara Tomy to reveal all this stuff already. We also have a brand new Takara Tomy battle hobby being revealed on the 3rd, and Beyblade, I think Duel Monsters or Duel Masters and Zoids, all those teams are developing it, so I'm probably going to report on that too. A lot of stuff is going to be coming up for Beyblade pretty soon, so hit that subscribe button so you guys can be up to date. Hit that like button. Once again, we are trying to hit 800 likes, and I will see you guys in the next one. Have fun. And bay away.